for the right and to bear the nation's might. And the army goes rolling along. Proud of all we have done, fight and fill the battle's won. And the army goes rolling along. And it's high, high day, the army's on its way. Proud of the king's on its far. For wherever we go, you will always know that the army goes rolling along.
Thank you. up these soldiers, groups at a time. They'll explain their weapon and then demonstrate how the weapon worked. First, we have grenadiers from the 23rd Royal Welsh Fusiliers. There you go.
We will go through, of course, the whole maneuver for you, and then we will turn around and we'll fire off for you. So, get started. Take care to prime and load. Prime and load!
Takes an awful long time.
So right about face. Make ready! Freeze and fire! Woo. Control the arm. Fire! To the right. Face!
The next soldier that we have coming up is a Union soldier from the Civil War.
We won!
I think it was 5-3.
Yeah, you know, but we won.
Yes.
Okay, everything he said, we do. Okay? I represent a soldier from the 119th New York Volunteers, which was actually mustered here in on Long Island in Hempstead Town. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to just demonstrate my weapon here, which is a reproduction of an 1861 Springfield. During the Civil War, they actually used Enfield rifles from Britain. Okay, this is a smoothbore rifle this is a rifled musket as opposed to a smoothbore, which means, like I mentioned before, it has twists in the barrel, makes the bullet come out like a football for more accuracy. This particular weapon, thank you, this is what the bullet looked like. It looks like a half a football. At the end, we'll actually, if you want to, I'll show it to you and explain it to you. Where was I? Okay. This weapon here had a range of about 1,500 yards, accurate between about 500 yards. It actually had a sighting area here where you could actually lift up the sights to get better accuracy. A well-trained Civil War soldier was taught to fire 3 rounds in a minute. That is very, very fast, considering. I will go through the demonstration on how to fire and how the soldier was taught how to fire. It's called loading in 9 separate steps to load this musket, which I will demonstrate right now. The soldier would be at a position of attention, and the order would be load in 9, load. At that point, he will take his rifle, put it between his legs, keep it about 8 inches from his body. He will, on my side here, I have my cartridge box. In my cartridge box, I have my ammunition. At that point, he'll say, handle cartridge. I'll open up my cartridge box, and I will take out 1 round, which looks very similar to this. I'm gonna reach into my cartridge box, my cap box, and I'm gonna pull out 1 cap. This is a brass cap, full of fulminate of mercury. I'm gonna put that on the cone. Okay, that's the 8th step. The 9th step would be shoulder arms. At the command, I'm gonna turn this way so nobody gets, when I'm ordered to fire, the command would be ready. I'm gonna come back, I'm gonna tee my feet. Aim, I'm gonna pull my hammer back all the way. Fire!
Nice.
Okay,
we're gonna
come back. Do it all over again. Do it all over again. 3 times in a minute. Very difficult to do.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
I'm Jim Lennon. I'm representing a Marine, 1890s Marine. Marines underwent a lot of transformation between the 1890 and 1900. This is the earlier one. All right. The weapon I'm firing is a trapdoor Springfield. The first, well, there were several varieties of them. The first model was taken, that Springfield rifle, and doing a conversion to it, put a trapdoor in the breech. Right, there's a single shot rifle, one shot at a time. It's a 45-70 round. That's the round there. It's a 45 caliber bullet on 70 grains of powder. It was one contained cartridge. All right, everything. The powder was in here. The primer was in here to set it off, and the bullet was in here. So this is a major transformation from what the Civil War and the Revolutionary War fellows were shooting. All right, so this was made it a lot easier. You can load a lot faster and carry more rounds. And firepower was the name of the game. All right, so this has a half cock, like the rest of them do. All right, just keep it in the safe mode. To load this, I'm gonna open my trap. I'm gonna take one of my rounds. This is a blank round. Feed it in here, close it, and I'm ready to fire. Now, as opposed to that 3 times in a minute deal, I can get a lot more rounds out of it.
Well, let's see how fast you can fly at 3 rounds, Corporal.
There you go. We'll see.
All right.
So, I can get them out of my belt, so.
Oh, yeah, no cheating.
All right.
I don't know, my second round be going off already, Jim.
Don't get nervous.
No pressure.
Nice.
So, now. Anyway. This is the powder that was fired, that this fire was black powder. The same powder the Revolutionary War guys were firing. You see the white smoke come out of it? Now imagine a line of infantry firing at the same time. You're gonna, and especially in a dense, humid environment, that smoke's gonna hang low, it's gonna obscure your vision. It's also gonna show the enemy where you are. Right? So, 1897, 1898, 1898, actually, the Marine Corps in particular adopted the 6mm Lee Navy rifle, which is a smokeless powder. So, that's the exact same powder that the Spanish are using in Cuba against us. So, I'll let our Spanish regular explain the rest.
Yes, buenas tardes, señores y señoras. I have the model 1895 Mauser. It's a German-made weapon. Germany made the finest weapons in the world at the time, at least repeating rifles. And they sold guns to everyone. This particular model was actually made for the Chilean government, but Spain was looking for rifles and Chile hadn't come up with the money yet, so Spain got the rifles instead of Chile. It fired the same 7mm bullet that their 1893 model used. It's a 5-shot clip fed. It feeds from a little stripper clip, which you put in here, you push them down, close the bolt, and the weapon's loaded. Now, this fired, as our Marine said, a smokeless powder. So there's going to be no telltale sign of where I'm firing from. Now, if he's shooting at me, I see the cloud of smoke, I can aim at him, I know where he's firing from. So this also had a higher velocity. The soldiers and Marines in Cuba and Puerto Rico and the Philippines used nicknamed the bullets that were flying by them the Spanish Hornets. So now I'm going to fire, and these are blanks, they can be temperamental, and hope I get off all 5 shots.
Hey.
One misfire.
Even the
less trained regulars can still get off pretty quickly compared to letting
them. Oh, there's too many people.
Well, what?
The group that I represent is the 1st Infantry Division, 16th Regiment. What I'm carrying is a 1903 Springfield. It's a 5-shot magazine.
Yeah.
A little bit more advanced. A little bit easier. 5 shots, both with a stripper clip.
The 03 Springfield was probably one of the most accurate rifles used by the U.S. Army and Marines. The actual design of it was actually copied from the German Mauser, and actually the Germans took them to World Court in order to get extra money out of them because they said they stole their patents. During the war, of course, they called them, now you're not getting any money. But the point is that the rifle was robust, it was quick to fire, it was very accurate, and it served us from World War I even through World War II. Unlike a lot of the armies in World War II who used bolt-action rifles, pretty much everyone did. The English did, the Italians did, the French, the Russians, the Japanese, and even the United States in the early parts of the war, you know, say the Battle of Guadalcanal. But the United States came up with the first semi-automatic gas-operated weapon that was probably the best battle rifle ever created, according to General Patton. It fired an 8-round internal clip, right, that made a distinctive noise when the clip popped out. Many of you have probably heard that saying, as of course, if you know anything about weapons, it makes a ping sound, all right, which originally gave its position away to the enemy. But of course, the Americans used their ingenuity, threw a clip up in the air and just waited for the guy to pop his head up when they heard the noise and took him out. So that didn't last very long. The rifle was robust. It was extremely accurate. They made sniper rifles out of this weapon. We were head and shoulders above all the other armies as far as the volume of firepower that we could. So as you can see, as opposed to the bolt action rifle that the Doughboy was using, which most armies were using even in World War II, you could see how many bullets he could shoot before the other guy had to reload. So we had 8 bullets as opposed to 5, and could fire them very fast. Last but not least, since we live in the state of New York and we can't demonstrate real machine guns, all right, we do have the next best alternative, which is gas power, just like the movies use in many cases.
We're going to come up to the line. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. We'll show you everything up close and personal if you'd like.
Right, we're going to shoot the machine gun.
Oh!
Yeah, we got one more to go.
One more.
All right. So, the half track that you see behind you is a T-16 half track. This is a World War II half track. It was also used in the Korean War. The back of the vehicle has been modified to take a turret mount, which will spin around. It was designed primarily for anti-aircraft use. It has 4 50 caliber machine guns. 50 caliber meaning that the diameter of the bullet is 1/2 inch. It's a big bullet. Each weapon fired 200 rounds a minute. Each weapon. You have 4 of them all in sync, coordinated with the sight. So that thing could spin around and take an aircraft out without a lot of problem. It was also used on occasion in a ground roll, firing against German, Japanese troops, all right, in order to take them out with bonsai charges or assaults that were on their positions. Commonly known as a meat grinder, all right. There's a lot of bullets flying through the air. You figure that's 1,000, that's 800 rounds a minute coming out of that piece, all right. Robust Browning 50 caliber machine gun is still in use today in our army. From World War II, when it was invented by John Browning, But today, they're still mounted on our M1 Abrams tanks. You can't beat it. There's nothing that comes close. It's one of the best weapons that were ever made for the military. We're going to demonstrate that right now. Muskets that way. I don't know. Anyway, thank you very much for listening to what we have to say about the weapons. We'll do more stuff later. There'll be vehicles going around. There'll be a horse demonstration later today. So please stick around and please come up to any of the soldiers and ask them any questions you want about their weapons, their uniforms, their equipment, and any of their gear.
I don't
want to
block his face.
Armed Forces Magazine.
Arm. Detail. Dismiss.
Thank you.
Cavalrymen from the Civil War would also carry a pistol, all right, and then also a shortened rifle called a carabine, all right. I don't have that with me right now. Also, you can see the saddle. There's all these like ties and things on here. I would also have blankets and other bags and stuff with other things that I needed. All right, because a lot of warfare was traveling, and the fastest way to move at that time was by horse. All right, in fact, some soldiers during the Civil War were actually, they would ride to battle, but then they would dismount, and then they would fight on foot. So another thing that's cool, if you know anything about horses, is that the horse wears a halter, so that, and it also has like a lead line attached already, so if I hop off, I can easily hook my horse up to another horse, and one soldier can hold a bunch of horses while the other soldiers go off and fight. So I think the course is all set up, and I'm going to go do my second run, okay?
An 1840 heavy cavalry saber, also known as a wrist breaker because it's so heavy. And this is the 1913 Patton saber, the last saber used by the U.S. Army. What's different?
Lighter.
A little bit lighter, but it's also...
straighter.
Straighter. He has to make a slashing movement, and I'm a pointing weapon. The point beats the blade. Who dies first?
I'm going to be so
He disappeared.
I'm assuming you want me somewhere in the
front. A bottle of wine? Right in front of the camera, Bill. We're still waiting for Jim Lennon.